Good morning, and how has it been with you guys over there? I hope you guys are keeping safe. Today, we all want to look at a complex sentence. This topic is a continuation of the first week. At the first week, we talked about intonation, introduction to intonation pattern, and we move ahead to talking about introduction to sentence, where I quickly mention the different kind of sentences, having introduced what a sentence is all about. So today we are going to single out all of the different type of sentence, starting with the complex sentence. According to the scheme of work, we said there are four types of sentences, which include the simple sentence, the compound sentence, the complex sentence, and the compound complex sentences. And these sentences are different in their variation. They are different in their formation, because what it entails is what one particular type of sentence entails is different from what the other one requires. So today we shall be looking at the complex sentence. The complex sentence usually pose a difficulty to most English students, because this type of sentence look at two key things: the independent clause and the subordinate clause. That's to say that it's a kind of sentence that contain an independent clause and a subordinate clause. Now, when you have an independent clause, it means that it is the main clause, it is the main verb. That kind of sentence can stand on its own and make complete sentence, but the subordinate clause cannot stand on their own to make complete sentence. And taking a look at what I have here with me, you will see that we have two different kind of sentence. First, we have the independent clause, that's the main sentence that can stand on its own and express complete thought. Here we said she was given an award. She was given an award. This sentence is independent because it can stand on its own. Now, we went ahead and said because she is a film star. Now, we want to know why she was given an award. The subordinate clause is it gives information, it gives additional information to the independent clause. Though it cannot stand on its own, but its role cannot be overemphasized, because without the subordinate clause, this independent clause will not be that rich, it will not be comprehensive. But here we said because she is a film star, you wouldn't have known why she was given an award if not that the subordinate clause was able to tell you that she was given an award because she is a film star. Number two, we have seen the pen. We have seen the pen. Of course, this is an independent clause because it expresses complete thought. It has its verb, it has its subject, and it has its object. Now, the next one is that was stolen. That was stolen. That was stolen lacks all the prerequisites to be called a sentence because it does not have the main clause. That is why it is called subordinate clause. So that was stolen gives additional meaning into the pen that has been seen. What about the pen? So the subordinate clause is giving information, additional meaning to the independent clause. So that's how the complex sentence work. You have the independent clause and you have the subordinate clause coming together to form complex sentence. Now, let's go back to the board and see what exactly is complex sentence. Complex sentence, just as I told you, is any sentence that consists of an independent clause and a subordinate clause. Now, example of independent clause, I want to single out a subordinate clause so that you will see how they are being formed. The subordinate clause are formed using relative pronouns or using connectives like a conjunctions. For instance, which I saw. This is a relative pronoun, which, because it's also is a conjunction, because he was responsible after leaving the house. Now, you will see that all of these statements does not stand on their own. All these clauses cannot express complete thoughts because there is no main verb here. Now, the subordinate clause only add details to what the independent clause is supposed to be doing or is supposed to be saying, because the independent clause has the subject, it has the action, it also has the object. That's to say that for you to say a sentence is independent, it must have a subject, an action, that's the main verb, and the object, that's the doer and the receiver of the action that was performed in that sentence. Now, here, let us look at how you can bring your subordinate clause and your independent clause together to express complete meaning so that it will be what? Comprehensive. Number one, we said, this is the dead animal which I saw yesterday. This is the dead animal which I saw yesterday. Now, this which here shows you that this is where the subordinate clauses begin. If you come to the class, or I come to the class and say, which I saw yesterday, which I saw yesterday, you will begin to think, what is wrong with your teacher? Because I'm not making complete sense. I'm not expressing a complete thought. You will not get the message. You will not get what I'm trying to pass across. But if, once I say, this is the dead animal, you will know that, yes, this particular subordinate clause is giving detail about the dead animal. Now, number two, I saw the boy. I saw the boy. That's a complete statement. It's a sentence. But who stole the box? Who stole the box here? With the help of this relative pronoun, it is telling you that it is giving this, it's giving additional information to the independent clause. After leaving the house, the thief's broken. Now, the reason why I wrote this sentence here is for you to know that the subordinate clause can be anywhere. It can be at the beginning, the middle, or the end of a sentence. Yes, it can be anywhere. Now, you see that after leaving the house, this is the subordinate clause. The thieves broke in. This is the independent clause that can stand on. So you should also know that the subordinate clause doesn't have to be at the end or in the middle. It can be anywhere in the sentence. Then number four, I spoke to Bola because he was responsible for the damage. I spoke to Bola because he was responsible for the damage. Then number five, we saw the bridge which the company constructed. Now, you should be very careful when you're making use of the relative pronoun. You should know that which is used for inanimate object, that is used for objects. It is not used for human being. But when you say who, WHO is used for human, then that is used for object. If you want to make you, if you want to refer to an object, trying to feature the subordinate clause. Number six, since he was tired, he went home so that he might rest. The main clause here, the independent clause, is he went home. So since he was tired, since here is also, this since is a conjunction, is a connective showing the subordinate clause. And here we also have so that he might rest. It means that this sentence alone has two independent clause. It means that the main clause is dependent on these two subordinate clauses to achieve its what meaning. So you should note that the subordinate clause can be anywhere, and it is usually introduced by either the relative noun, the relative pronouns, or connectives to show, to be able to join the independent and the subordinate clause together. So what are we saying in essence? Complex sentence has to do with independent and subordinate clauses coming together, making use of the relative pronouns or the connectives. You must also note that the subordinate clause cannot stand on its own. It is just like a backup. It gives additional information to what the main or the independent clause is talking about. That is complex sentence. That is why it is called complex, because it must have an independent clause and it must have one or two subordinate clauses, as we have seen in this last sentence. So there's something I want you to do here. One, explain the meaning of complex sentence. What is complex sentence? Number two, write three examples of subordinate clause. If you have gone through the entire class with me, you will know that I started introducing this topic by telling you what a complex sentence is and how a subordinate clause is formed. Then number three, construct three sentences showing complex sentence. This is the most salient part of our topic, of our lesson, knowing how to form complex sentences. So if you go over the notes, read it, or you can call me, or reach out to me if there is any question. Thank you.